house, you eat whatever thing you want, you drive whatever car you want to drive, you can never make your own money. Let your brother wife come in and say, that's your junior brother, he has to go. I don't want you to use any of my husband's car. I don't want you to use any of my brother's property. Leave our house. When your brother's wife is attacking you, she may hate you, but it's a prophecy that she is pushing you to be a man. Am I talking here? You see that? So we see things differently. Our perception is different. So if you don't have this perception, ability to see the truth or something from the ways of men, then you will see everything they are saying as a cause or hatred. Praise the Lord. But when somebody refuses to give you, you will try hard to buy it. Praise the Lord. May your perception open. In the name of Jesus. So you can perceive from the word of God and from the word of man. Now let me show you something from the word of God that you can perceive. John chapter 11. John chapter 11. Then let us read it to from 50. Okay, let's read from 50. Amen. Is anybody there? John chapter 11. Okay, let's take it from verse 45. John chapter 11 from verse 45. He said, then many of the Jews will come to Mary and have seen things which Jesus did, believe on him. Amen. Amen. Then verse. Okay, let me take it from verse 49. 49 is better. Amen. Amen. Now here is 49. John chapter 11 from verse 49 says, and one of them named Caiaphas, being the high priest, that same year said unto them, all of you know nothing at all. All of you, these people that are saying King Jesus, that Jesus is fake, he carried devil and all of that, you don't know anything, he said. Verse 50, nor consider that it is expedient for us. The word expedient there is better. It is better for us that one man should die for the people and that the whole nation perish. You see that? The neighbor says something there. So the man said, don't you know that it is better for one man to die? They want to kill Jesus. They want to destroy Jesus. They were angry of Jesus. They were jealous of him. They don't want his ministry. And they decided to kill him. Some said, don't kill him. Some said, kill him. And he said, don't you know that it's better for us to kill him? It's better for Jesus to die so that he be one man to die so that the whole nation will be saved. It's better for him to die so that the whole nation be saved than the whole nation to die for only one man to save. It's like a question. Do you want the whole nation to die or you want one man to die? He tried to convince them. It's better for us that a man should die so that the whole nation will be saved. And verse 51. This spoke he not of himself, but being a high priest, he prophesied that Jesus should die for the nation. Now watch this. This man didn't know what he said. Did anybody catch something there? Caiaphas didn't know what he said. He said, it is better for this man to die so that the whole nation will be saved, thinking that he wants to punish Jesus. But he didn't know that he prophesied. He didn't know that it was a prophecy. These are ways of men that you can find prophecy inside. Let's kill Jesus so that the whole nation will be saved. Let's destroy him. Let's destroy his ministry. And when he was doing that, he didn't know he was prophesying. in the world of men. May God open your eyes to see what you need from the advice of men. May God open your eyes to see what you need, to see what will make you successful from the ways of men. In the name of Jesus. So you can see prophecy concerning your life from the word of man. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Look at the same John chapter 8. The same John chapter 8. I would like somebody to help me. John chapter 8 from verse 40 from verse 47. John 8 from verse 47. Are we there? Now look at what he said. He that is of God hears the word of God. All of you therefore hear them not because you are not of God. Amen. Amen. You don't hear him because you are not of God. Then verse 48. Then answered the Jews and said unto him, say we not well that you are a Samaritan and have a devil? And Jesus answered, I have not a devil, but I honor my Father. Amen.
Amen.
I am not the devil. I honor my Father. Now, what's from the argument? If you read down there, you will see the argument. You're a devil. You are possessed. Now, this man that are saying that Jesus is carrying devil, that Jesus is possessed, that means they are not confirmed as God's people. That means they are not the children of God. Amen.
Amen.
They are accusing him. They were not the children of God at all. Is anybody hear what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
These men are not the children of God. So that was why they were accusing Jesus, saying that Jesus Christ carried the devil, he is that, you know. And at the end of the day, they were not able to see what Jesus was saying. They were not able to see prophecy. They were not able to perceive something from the word of God. Amen. Your spirit must always receive the word of God so that the prophecy will come afresh in you.
Amen.
And when that prophecy comes, anything can happen. Anything can happen.
Amen.
I say anything can happen.
Amen.
Healing can take place.
Amen.
Deliverance can take place.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So you perceive the word, you perceive prophecy from the word of God. You perceive prophecy from the word of man. Hallelujah. The next is, the breath of God is a weapon to destroy the power of death. Hebrews chapter 2. Hebrews chapter 2. The breath of God that gives you life. The breath of God that quickens your spirit. The breath of God that opens your perception is capable of destroying the power of death. Is anybody there? Hebrews chapter 2. If you are there, let me hear you say amen.
Amen.
Verse 14, can you read it for me? Hebrews chapter 2. From verse 14, are we there?
No.
Alright, let me read. He said, for so much then as the children are partaker of flesh and blood, he also himself likewise took part of the same, that through death he might destroy him that has the power of death. That is who? The devil. Somebody say power of death.
Power of death.
Say power of death.
Power of death.
Hallelujah. That means death has power. No wonder if you hold somebody, the person will come back again. Amen.
Amen.
That means death has what?
Power.
The word death is a name, but there is a power behind that death. Anyone that is in the ground, there's a power holding him there. There's a power holding the person down. And that power can last eternity. Can hold the person there forever. Amen. There are powers behind it. Lift up your hands. Heavenly Father, by your special breath, every power of death that is assigned to any family, that is assigned to anyone under the sound of my voice, by the new introduction of your breath, as a new life enters into anyone here, as a new life enters into your family, may the power of death be destroyed. May the power of death be destroyed. May the power of death be destroyed. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, my Father. Hallelujah. So the breath of God is a weapon to destroy the power of death. And in Hebrews said, for so much then as Jesus, or for so much then as the children and the partaker of flesh of blood, Jesus himself likewise took part of the same nature, that through death he might destroy him that has the power of death. He might destroy him that has the power of death. And that is the devil. Devil has no life. Remember, he has come to kill, to steal, and to destroy. But I have come that you may have life and have it more abundantly. Life comes from God, and the death comes from Satan. Therefore, in the name of Jesus Christ, any family here that is hearing the sound of my voice, that the devil is roaring, that the devil is causing, that the power of death is holding power, in the name of Jesus Christ, by the new breath of God, let the new life enter your family. Let the new life enter your family. And the bread, the powers of death. And bread, the powers of death. And bread, the powers of death. In the name of Jesus. Something came into my spirit now as I read this scripture. I want you to look into that scripture as I read it again. For so much then as the children are partakers of flesh and blood, Jesus, he also himself likewise took part of the same, that through death he might destroy him that have the power of death. He might destroy him that have the power of death. There's a power of death, and there's someone that have the power of death. He might destroy him that had the power of death. Lift up your right hand. Father, in the name of Jesus. Amen. Whosoever that have the power of death that is terrorizing any member of your family, by the new birth, as you hear the sound of my voice, let the power of death be taken away from the holder. Amen. I said, be taken away from the holder. 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 In the name of Jesus, anyone that has the power of death, that boasts that I have the power of death, I can kill, I can take somebody's life. Somebody may be holding that power, post it in your family, post it around you. In the name of Jesus, whosoever that is holding death, whosoever that has the power of death, anywhere around you, by the blast of Jehovah, I command that power to be taken from you. Let the hand of the man be exalted. Let the power come out from the hand. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hear me. God has taken away power of death from the holder. Whosoever that holds the power of death that terrorizes your family, that power has been destroyed in his hands. I said that power has been destroyed in his hands. In the name of Jesus. So the breath of God is a weapon to destroy the powers of death. Therefore, receive a new breath. May the blast of his nostrils destroy every power of death and destroy the holder of the power of death. In the name of Jesus. So by fight with death. Listen, nobody dies without appointment. You may not know, it may be strange to you, but nobody dies without what? Appointment. I want you to show me carefully here. Jesus took part of the nature of him and destroyed the power of death. How that power of death come in operation in your life? How, when it comes, how did it operate? It operated by appointment. I tell you, listen to me. Nobody just dies. Everybody dies on a particular day, a particular date, particular time. He died on Wednesday, August 2006 and so, by so time. And all this time date is an appointment. I will show you from the scripture. It's an appointment. If you don't have an appointment within the office, you have no business to go to that office. If you don't have an appointment with anybody, you have no business to meet with anyone. Anyone you meet is somebody you have an appointment with. Whoever that dies, dies under appointment. But the truth is that many are in appointment on the way. Men are in appointment on the way. That is why they are taking on the way. If they know, if anybody knows they have an appointment with death, you will do everything to cancel that appointment. But people don't know, that is why. When the time of Jesus to die came, he submitted. He said, this is the time. Because that is an appointed time. Remember, it's appointed unto man to die once. So death is appointed. Whether good man or bad man is an appointment. But see something here. See something here. Psalm 102. Lord, I give you name. Somebody, every death appointed, moving anywhere around you, is cancelled forever. Yeah. That angel is too weak. Yeah. I said, any death that is moving anywhere around you is cancelled forever. Yeah. In the name of Jesus. What the breath of God gives you. It gives you freedom. Amen. Psalm 102. Psalm 102. From verse 18. Are we there? Psalm 102. From verse 18. Now here we say, this shall be written for the generations to come. So, it sounds like a prophecy. This is the ministry for the generation to come. And that the people which shall be created shall praise the Lord. 19. For he looked down from the height of his sanctuary. From heaven did he behold the earth. To hear the groaning of the prisoners. To look those that are appointed to die. To hear the groaning of the prisoners, and so as to lose them that are appointed to die. It's only God that can disappoint the appointment of death. Did you see something there? He is looking down from the height of the sanctuary, beholding the earth, searching for those who have appointment with death. Listen, heaven is open. The eyes of God is coming down to your family. Yeah. God is looking for someone that has appointment with death. Therefore, if there's anyone among you that has been appointed to die, has appointment with death, with the shout of amen this hour, I see that appointment disappointed. 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 In the name of Jesus. Death is a wicked thing. Death is a terrible thing. Poverty you can bear. Sickness you can get well. But when death enters family, it silences everyone. It scatters every arrangement. It is arranged. Every plans. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Nobody dies if he does not have an appointment. Therefore, whosoever that is under appointment with death, knowingly or unknowingly, in the name of Jesus Christ, by the power of his breath, may a new life enter into you. And may the appointment of death be disappointed. May God cancel that appointment. I said, may God cancel that appointment. Cancel it in your family. Cancel it on your children. Cancel it on your life. Cancel it everywhere around you. I pray in the name of Jesus that every appointment with death is hereby canceled by heaven. 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 In the name of Jesus. Listen, you are privileged to know that when a new breath enters into you, when the breath of God comes to your life, come on here. He gives you an understanding, ability to know what is coming and what you have to do. Ability to know what is in place for you. Sir, every man that dies, dies under appointment. And that is why you can cause an appointment. It doesn't matter who you have the appointment with. He can refuse to attend to that meeting. Is anybody with me?
Yes, sir.
If you have an appointment with me, you can cancel the appointment. You see, that meeting, I brought you, we can meet it. You can cancel it. Amen. You can decide not to attend to the meeting. But the worst mistake you will do is to attend to the meeting. If you attend to the meeting, if you attend to that appointment with death, then you must fulfill what you went there for. But you can say, I cannot attend to that meeting. You can stand and counsel the ordinances. Counsel the handwriting. Counsel the appointment with the devil. Listen, it can be a choice. Amen.
Amen.
He looked down from the heart of his sanctuary to behold the earth. Why? So as to see those. God is searching for anyone that has an appointment with us. God is looking for somebody that has an appointment with death. So he can lose you from that appointment.
Amen.
He can catch you that appointment.
Amen.
Lift up your finger up. Lord, I am here. Come on, say,
Lord, I am here.
Lord, I am here.
In the name of Jesus.
See, he said, he is looking down from the height of what? Of where? Sanctuary. Doing what? Looking for those who have appointments with death. That if you signify that here I am, then he sees you. Once again, Father, I am here. My family is here.
My
children are here. Lord, my family is here. My children are here. Lord, we are here. In the name of Jesus. Let me show you a man that canceled appointment with death. A man, he's called Peter. Somebody say Peter. So a day came when they were sailing, and while they were in the boat, they looked and they saw Jesus. They said, this could be Master. Master, is that you? He said, yes, I am. And they said, he is even walking on top of the water. Bid me to come. And the Master said, come. And then Peter stepped out of the boat, and then he began to walk on the water. Life was easy, it was good. But the time came when something happened and he began to sink. When he was sinking, death was throwing him. That was answer to death. Nobody knew that it was an appointment for Peter to end his ministry, to end his journey that day. But something happened. The Bible says, and God is looking down. He is up, he's looking down, and he's looking to see someone who has an appointment with death. And the only way God can see you is when you raise up your hand. And Peter knew that this appointment with death is about to be accomplished. And he lifted up his hands and he cried for help. Jesus heard him and he drew him out. Lift up your hands. Father, in the name of Jesus. Lord, these ones are signs to show that they are here. These ones, their hands in the air, is a sign to show they are here. Therefore, Father, as they lift up their hands for help, lift them up, O Lord. Rise them up, O Lord. Is hereby cancelled forever. I say is hereby cancelled forever. I say is hereby cancelled forever. Is hereby cancelled forever. In the name of Jesus. Listen. Let me show you another appointment with death. Two appointments with death I want to show you now. Remember, he said, who shall I release to you? Barabbas or Jesus? And they said, set Barabbas free and then release Jesus for us to crucify. Everything that Jesus was doing, all that happened was revolving around his death. The death of Jesus was an appointment. You know that? He came to die. And when the time came, he said, this is the time. He told him, he said, the hour has come. He told Judas before the time, he said, the hour has come. That which you want to do, do it again. Amen.
Amen.
Because it was an appointment. Hallelujah. But that man, Barabbas had also appointments because he was condemned, waiting for a particular time to be crucified. But that appointment was cancelled. Can I tell you something?
Yes.
There was an exchange. Jesus gave his life for Barabbas. Barabbas, go home. Let me die for you. Hear me. Your appointment with death is cancelled.
Yeah.
I say your appointment with death is cancelled.
Yeah.
And then we saw a man who was crucified together with Jesus. Two men were crucified together with Jesus. That was the appointed time. Amen.
Amen.
The day came, they brought them and they crucified them together. Appointed time. Hallelujah. I don't know why I'm saying this, but something is telling me that a covenant of death is broken today.
Yeah.